We'll be seeing the Japanese tag team in action today.
That's right, Gordon. Mr. Onita and Masa Fuji, they've turned out to be one of the top tag teams to come from the country of Japan, but they're going to be facing somebody that Abe Jacobs, who we all know is a recognized international star, along with the young Winnipeg, Canada star, Ron Ritchie.
It's going to be quite an hour indeed. Also, Chick Donovan in action. And as I said, of course, Barbara Cleary is here. And Barbara, your pick five this week concerns the former Florida heavyweight champion, Barry Windham.
Yes, Gordon, it concerns Barry Windham Mulligan, and I'll be talking a little bit about why he's decided to use the name Mulligan and why he lost the Florida title. He wants it back.
He does indeed, and of course, he never did lose that title in a match, that's for sure. Let me take a moment right now to call in Mr. J.J. Dillon. Mr. Dillon, of course, has been appealing to the National Wrestling Alliance regarding Avalanche Tyler, but I understand, Mr. Dillon, that you've been about 50% successful. The spoiler, who is a Florida heavyweight champion, back in action, but Tyler is not.
That's true. I went to the NWA to appeal my case. I ran into a stone wall. They said there's no compromising with what took place. The suspension stands. I asked the NWA to intervene on my behalf with Championship Wrestling to get the ban lifted on the spoiler appearing on television again. I got no cooperation whatsoever, but I went direct to the Championship Wrestling officials. I explained the situation. The match was over at the time the incident took place. The decision had been rendered. The other man came back in the ring of his own volition. It was questionable whether he came in to do bodily harm to me. I am the manager of the spoiler. Possibly his actions were justified, and they felt after being barred for 2 weeks, Championship Wrestling had made their point. I figured I've won my point, that the Florida heavyweight champion is back on television where he belongs. And good to my word, the challenge I made last week stands. I'm putting up $1,000 today. He will beat two men with the claw and do it within 10 minutes right now today.
All right, there you have it, the comments from J.J. Dillon himself, and we will be seeing the spoiler in action in a special handicap match. Remember now, he must pin these two men with the claw, I understand, within 10 minutes. So that should be interesting indeed. By the way, we certainly want to issue a special word of congratulations to a very, very hard-working individual, not only professionally in professional wrestling, but as public service work as well. Dusty Rhodes, who has been appointed the state campaign manager for the American Cancer Society, is the honorary state chairman. I understand later this month he and Larry Hagman, the star of Dallas, will be having some functions here in the state of Florida. All of this and more upcoming during this next hour, so by all means do stay tuned. We have Buzz Sawyer coming up in the ring momentarily. Mr. Dillon, we'll be looking to see your man, the spoiler, in action a little later. Fair enough. Let's turn it to our ring announcer.
This match, one fall, with a 10-minute time limit from Samoa, weighing 228 pounds, Coco Samoa. His opponent from St. Petersburg, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, Buzz Sawyer.
All right. It is Buzz Sawyer going up against Coco Samoa. I just mentioned that Sawyer, of course, has had a $5,000 challenge up here for some time, and he is caught very nicely by Samoa that time. Samoa brings him up into a full body slam.
I've been openly negotiating with Buzz Sawyer. He realizes what I've been able to do for the careers of several other young athletes with his potential, and he sees what I can do for him, and I understand what he can do for me, because he is a top-notch competitor. He's got the credentials, he's got the youth, he's got the size, he's got the endurance, he's got everything going for him, and he would definitely be an asset to my stable. I'm taking a good hard look at him, he's taking a good hard look at me, and we may have a very important announcement to make within the next week or so, but I'll openly welcome him into my camp.
Indeed, so, but Buzz Sawyer being looked at by J.J. Dillon. And, Jerry, all I can say there is that with Dillon's tutelage and management, Sawyer could become an increasingly dangerous object in the ring.
Well, you're exactly right, Gordon. And J.J. Dillon, boy, we can't sell him short recognizing talent like a Buzz Sawyer, because this young man's got nothing but bright stars ahead of him. But Coco Samoa might rapidly change the whole outlook on both Buzz Sawyer's part and J.J. Dillon, because, as we said before, Coco Samoa can strike like lightning.
Back up into those ring ropes now. Referee Bill Alfonso trying to get them separated. Sawyer takes him off the ropes. Caught Samoa from behind. A clubbing blow into the back of the head. Has Samoa down outside the ring on the concrete. Sawyer moving against him very quickly, driving the flat of the foot into the side of the neck and side of the jaw of Coco Samoa. And he caught him exactly right, coming past him. And it is Samoa driven back into the ring, and Buzz Sawyer taking full advantage of the situation here, but the crowd picking up a chance for Coco to go, and they are solidly with Coco Samoa.
Buzz Sawyer is always in action. He's always got his motion going. He's always an aggressive type competitor. And, Gordon, that's what champions are made out of. But you don't give Coco Samoa a break or any kind of opening, or he'll get those quick hands going just as he did. Buzz Sawyer might have had a lapse there. Coco Samoa, thinking a step ahead of him, was able to reverse it and swing him right into the turnbuckle.
And Samoa paying Sawyer back with some of his own medicine now. Using those pistols were effectively caught him in the throat coming off the ropes. Samoa now very, very quickly trying to turn the tide of this match. Sawyer into those ring ropes. The referee calls for the break. Samoa again, a high backdrop, and it is Buzz Sawyer back to the canvas, getting up rather slowly, Jerry. It is Sawyer leapfrogging up and over his man, and Sawyer now meets, wow, beautiful power slam. Samoa going for a cross body block. And there again we see the great versatility of Buzz Sawyer. Tremendous physical control over his body. Took what appeared to be a certain cross body block, turned it to his own advantage into a power slam, scored the pinfall, and the victory. So Buzz Sawyer is victorious once again.
This match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Canada, weighing 230 pounds, Ron Ritchie. His partner from New Zealand, weighing 240 pounds, Abe Jacobs. Their opponents from Japan had a combined weight of 450 pounds, Masafuchi and Mr. Onita.
Masafuchi and Mr. Onita, the team that Jerry was talking about at the beginning of the program, going up against Abe Jacobs and Ron Ritchie. And if you were to try and handicap these two teams, I think I would certainly have to go along with Jerry. This has got to be rated as strictly a toss-up.
Well, it certainly is. With Abe Jacobs' experience in there and Ron Ritchie's enthusiasm and desire, it's going to be one heck of a match. If these Japanese wrestlers, well, they've got a way about this teamwork. They know their basic wrestling. They've been schooled in it just like their sumos, Gordon. They start at a very, very young age, and they work up, and they don't come out of the country of Japan unless they're absolutely ready.
Uchi dumped to the canvas and caught again by Ron Ritchie. Ron Ritchie, a series of good arm drag takedowns, and Onita moves into the ring as Fuchi moves out. And Ritchie giving him a dose of the same medicine. And so now Onita is also out of the ring. Fuchi and Onita. They, of course, Jerry, you and Jack being the North American Tag Team Champions, I know that's something they have their eye on.
Well, it certainly is. Any time that that there is a title up and you've got a tag team like Fuji and Onita, they're going to be looking for championships, and you cannot duck. Now, what a beautiful drop kick by Ron Ritchie. A beautiful wing over right up into an arm bar.
Abe Jacobs makes the tag, moves in, top wrist lock, and Onita getting the takedown momentarily. Well, Jacobs back out on top again with a hammerlock on Onita. Interesting, you can hear the crowd shouting USA, and they have automatically aligned Abe Jacobs out of New Zealand and Ron Ritchie out of Canada as USA and representing the North American hemisphere, and it is Jacobs once again keeping the hammerlock on Onita, keeping Onita down to the canvas, and as willing as they are to move into the air, Ritchie particularly with those flying drop kicks, it's interesting to note that both Ritchie and Jacobs have been bringing their men to the mat.
Well, that's right, Gordon. Basic wrestling is what it's all about, and there's no better exponents of it than Abe Jacobs. And he knows that if you're going to beat a man, you got to tie him up, you got to get him on that mat, and you got to wear him down. And so far, he's been able to relay this to his partner, Ron Ritchie. But the young Japanese man has a different ideal as he goes for the hair pull and escapes and makes the tag.
All right, Ron Ritchie. Tried to move in on his man, tried to duck under Goran. It was Fucci catching him now. Belly to back souffle that has Ritchie back to the canvas, a float over by Fucci. Ritchie powers out before the count of three. It is Fucci once again, full arm drag and twist, now makes the tag with Mr. Onita. Onita up on that second ring, down across the back of the head of Ron Ritchie. And Onita moving even more effectively on Ritchie now. And the constant teamwork of Onita and Fucci may be beginning to take its toll now on Ron Ritchie and the team of Ron Ritchie and Abe Jacobs. Ritchie.
So far, they've been able to contain Onita and Fucci have been able to contain Ritchie and Abe Jacobs to their side. But now the tide has turned and the momentum seems to be switching back since he was able to tag Jacobs in for a fresh tag. He's got both the Japs reeling and rocking.
Jacobs now letting Fucci have it and catches him coming off the ropes now. Backdrop. Jacobs closing in again. Onita starts to charge in. Buddy Colt, the referee. Colt, of course, former North American heavyweight champion. And as we've said so many, many times about this man, a great athlete. And Colt trying to clear the ring of the one of the, and he has cleared the ring. He has disqualified the Japanese for the karate. He disqualified Onita and Fucci, and it was quite obvious that, as Colt is indicating, they tried a karate thrust to the throat, and Buddy Colt, former North American champion, now an outstanding official, ruling with an iron hand there, disqualifies the Japanese team. So the winners via disqualification, Jacobs and Ritchie.
Just look at what your participating Carvel ice cream store has for the holidays. Isn't that beautiful? They have Tom the Turkey or a complete serving tray full of Carvel special ice creams. You can buy any one of these items or the entire tray, or if you'll call this toll-free number, you may purchase the entire gift tray. If you want 100 or 1,000 for your employees or just one delivered to a friend, please call this number. MasterCharge and Visa cards are accepted. Thank you.
You know, here at Adams Chevrolet and Federal Highway in Delray Beach, we should really call it No Problem Motors, because there's no problem. All it takes is $49 to take delivery of any new or used car in stock. So for goodness sakes, when you get in there, I'm going to show you a buy and a half. How about a 75 Volvo wagon? You know the dealer that asked for this, the Volvo dealer? About $4,995. Here, it's only $2,988, if you please. Would you hurry up, get it here? How about an 80 Chevette? $49 to $119 a month, for goodness sakes. How long do I have to keep screaming and shouting at you?
Gulfstream Seafood Restaurant and Market announces the grand opening of its newest location. Enjoy fresh seafood caught daily direct from Gulfstream's own fleet in West Palm Beach and now in Delray Beach. Whether it's oysters and clams from the Raw Bar, fresh Maine lobster, shrimp, or the catch of the day, Gulfstream has it all at prices that will fit your family budget. After dinner, visit the Gulfstream Seafood Market, offering the freshest and largest selection of seafood in town. The Gulfstream Seafood Restaurant and Market on Georgia Avenue in West Palm Beach and now in the Delray Mall, South Federal Highway, Delray Beach.
So I figured if I'm sick enough to see my doctor, I'm sick enough to get a prescription. You know, when you're not feeling good, you want to get well, you need medicine, right? One day my doctor sat me down and made it clear to me that you take medicines only when you need them. And what I needed was to eat different food, get more exercise. You know, he was right.
Don't expect a prescription every time you see your doctor. And follow your doctor's advice. A message from the Food and Drug Administration.
All right, we have a special handicap match coming up now. J.J. Dillon in the ring with the Florida heavyweight champion, the Spoiler. And Bruno Sammartino and Wild Bill Snyder set to go against... Wild Bill Snyder and Eric Embry moving into the ring. Eric Embry moving in, and I believe Dillon... Well, apparently Sammartino Jr. has missed a flight. He is currently competing up in around the Georgia area, but apparently has missed a flight. Let's see what J.J. Dillon's going to do about this. Jerry appears to be giving his okay on the situation.
Well, he sure does. You know, Eric Emery's the one that started this Dillon's bank account running in the red, I believe. He took $1,000 from it.
Handicap match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Seattle, Washington, weighing 220 pounds, Wild Bill Snyder. His partner from Maysville, Kentucky, weighing 222 pounds, Nitro Eric Embry. His opponent from Singapore, weighing 270 pounds, the Florida heavyweight wrestling champion, James J. Dillon, presents the Spoiler.
Spoiler, the Florida heavyweight champion, and I don't know if you saw that or not, but that belt's a mess. He won the Florida title. I noticed J.J. Dillon covering it up very quickly. The Spoiler, as the Florida heavyweight champion, apparently has used that belt pretty badly damaged it. So the Spoiler moving against two opponents now. Embry out there first against the Spoiler, and the Spoiler has him up a full body slam. Eric Embry, who cost J.J. Dillon $1,000. Now Embry goes for that sleeper. No, sir. A little bit too tall. And Embry caught him very nicely. Embry up with a beautiful drop kick that drives the Spoiler back into the rope. Embry somersaulting away, ducking away to one side. And Embry, using his great speed, slips away from the Spoiler. And Wild Bill Snyder moves out.
Was J.J. Dillon over there checking his time already, Gordon. I'm sure he don't want to see what happened, Eric Emery was able to do to his bank book before.
J.J. Dillon managing the Spoiler, who is the current Florida heavyweight champion and has a very careful eye on Buzz Sawyer. You see Mr. Dillon watching the situation with a great deal of interest. And there's the Spoiler walking that top rope. And to see a man with that kind of balance is almost uncanny. And catches Snyder. Snyder back to his feet. Embry charges in. Gets a shot on the Spoiler and ducks away from him. And as he did, the Spoiler's attention diverted Wild Bill Snyder in behind him. And the Spoiler at a loss here as Snyder trying to get him back into the ring. He would like very much to get a pinfall or at least hold this man off. Remember now, the Spoiler has to defeat both men with the claw in 10 minutes. And time is certainly on the side of Eric Embry and Wild Bill Snyder.
Embry's been using his head in there, Gordon. He's been able to distract the Spoiler several times. The Spoiler has probably been schooled by J.J. Dillon to watch this young man, Embry. So Embry is using these little tactics on the outside of the ring to divert his attention. Also, the biggest thing about it, Gordon, it's killing some time.
Exactly. The clock continues to roll, and it is the Spoiler keeping the pressure now on Wild Bill Snyder. But remember, both men have to be pinned within the 10 minutes. Spoiler came down, but the Snyder was out of the way. Snyder moves over, makes the tag. And Embry, he is Fly like a fox. You notice how much time he took before he came into the ring. He knows those seconds count.
He knows the count. He's got the count of five to get in, and he used every one of them, and he's trying to run that clock down. He's using that that evasive style right now, Gordon, and you're in there against a man that size. He's got all the time in the world. Spoiler's got to come and get him and defeat him, and J.J. Dillon has now strolled right up the ringside, and he's starting to worry a little bit.
Time continues to move, and it is Embry with a full body slam at the hands of the Spoiler. And so the Spoiler now. And, you know, we talked about the situation. When you stop to think about it, the Spoiler is, in fact, moving against constantly two fresh opponents. And one has to give this man, the Spoiler, tremendous credit for fantastic conditioning, great courage, and just about half the time is gone. Just about half the time is gone right now. And it is the Spoiler continuing to move against Wild Bill Snyder's Embry, getting a rest outside the ring, a backbreaker on Snyder. Embry started to move in, and the Spoiler catches both of them, crashes their heads together. It is Embry driven outside the ring. There you see Dillon giving those instructions to the Spoiler, and now it is the Spoiler catching Wild Bill Snyder a good high knee lift. The Spoiler takes him off the ropes, catches him with a claw. He's got the claw on Wild Bill Snyder and drives Snyder to the mat. Has Snyder down. So 50% of his chore is accomplished now. Embry starts to come back into the ring, and the Spoiler on him very quickly, but more than 50% of the time is gone. So if it takes him the same length of time to catch up with Eric Embry, he could be in trouble. But right now, he seems to have Eric Embry completely under his own domination.
Well, he's eliminated one half of the team. Took a little bit longer because he was fighting two fresh guys. Now he's in there against Eric Embry. He was able to sling Eric Embry outside of the ring, weaken him while he was able to defeat Wild Bill Snyder. Now young Eric Emery's got an awesome task facing him trying to defeat this man.
It's a different ball game this time, Gordon, so they tell it like it is. He's got him at his will right now, and I've instructed the Spoiler. I want him to punish this man, and I don't want him beaten until there's 10 seconds left.
Well, we've heard the comments from J.J. Dillon, and it is Eric Embry taking a lot of punishment here. Wild Bill Snyder has been removed. The two competitors came out and took Wild Bill Snyder back to the dressing room, where he was suffering from the effects of that claw. And it is the Spoiler now. Sets Embry with the claw. Has the claw on Eric Embry. And so the Spoiler now. And Embry battling his way back to his feet. Embry trying desperately to get back to his feet. Embry, left and a right. And it is the Spoiler hanging on with that claw. And great credit has to go to Eric Embry. He is not conceded at this point. Again, credit has to go to the Spoiler. He is taking on a second fresh man. J.J. Dillon at ringside, and now the Spoiler gets set, puts the claw back on Embry. His face rapidly turning crimson. And you can hear Dillon making a comment about there's 1 minute left. There's 1 minute left. And the Spoiler pulls Embry off the ropes.
45 seconds, Gordon.
Time is rapidly running out. He's got the claw on Embry. The referee knocked to one side. He has the claw on Embry. He's got Embry down. And wait a minute. Dillon moving in. Dillon moving in.
He came through that, Gordon.
Well, Dillon can pull the count all day long. It doesn't do any good. It doesn't do any good because the referee is not there. Now Dillon desperately trying to get referee Bill Alfonso back in the ring. Bill Alfonso being helped into the ring by J.J. Dillon. Embry down on the canvas, and the time is rapidly running out. There's the bell. The bell has rung.
Saved him. Eric Embry, the $1,000 in his pocket now.
The bell has rung. It is all over. The spoiler has the cloth. There was no three count. There was not a three count. The time limit expired.
We've done it, Gordon. Surely I showed him. I've got him out of my hair once and for all. We squashed him like a bug. I've done it just like I said I would. The spoilers beat them both.
Wait just a minute. Just a second. There was no three count to the way I saw it. I certainly didn't hear a three count. I thought I heard the bell ring.
What do you mean, no three count? You must be blind. Are you deaf or something? I heard it. The referee came down with a three before the bell.
No, I don't. I'll tell you what. I'm not sure. We may have a replay of that. I'll tell you what. Let's just, for your edification, for mine and for all of you watching. All right, here it is now. All right, here's the referee being brought back in by you, and he was knocked to one side. All right, you're explaining to the referee. Three down on the canvas, and the time is rapidly running out. There's the bell. The bell has rung.
Saved him. Eric Emery's $1,000 in his pocket now.
Two counts there. Two counts. That's another $1,000.
$1,000!
Get it! What does it mean, get it? Oh, wait a minute. The spoiler going back in. The spoiler catching Mike Bond, Gordon Nelson, and Dorb Roach, and Eric Embry is in horrible shape out there. And the spoiler puts the claw back on J.J. Dillon, catching Gordon Nelson. And, well, we've got the spoiler now. Young Eric Embry. And wait a minute. Mr. USA, Bugsy McGraw, charges the ring. Bugsy McGraw catching the spoiler. Bugsy McGraw after the spoiler nine. He breaks it up in a hurry. Bugsy McGraw broke that up in a hurry. And let me get on over there. Let me get on over. Charging that ring, and the match was over when J.J. Dillon sent the spoiler back in to issue more punishment to Eric Embry. Eric Embry, saved by the bell, cost J.J. Dillon $1,000 more, and it is Bugsy McGraw picking up Eric Embry, and Embry in bad shape indeed. Eric Embry in bad shape as he is suffering the effects of that claw. And thank heavens that Bugsy McGraw certainly came in and sought his own kind of justice after what he saw was going on. I don't know if Bugsy wants
to. I'm going to talk. Enough is enough. Understand? I've been watching this boy. This Eric Embry. And before, I tell you what, I really thought he was just lucky. Lucky, understand me? This boy's not lucky. This boy's got the guts of a giant. Of a giant. You understand me? I know what's inside his soul now. I know what's inside his heart. He's got freedom and USA written right across his very existence. And brother, I found out something about him. Every week he writes his mama and sends home half of his money. Now, brother, that's what I call a real sacrifice. I'm going to let the people know right now. And Eric, brother, if you want to march to the gates of hell and right through them, brother, I'm going to be right there with you, right by your side. And I'm telling people, you, J.J. Dillon, the spoiler, Bud Sawyer, Jaggers, who's ever watching me, if you want this young man's soul, you're going to have to walk right through me. Eric Embry, you are USA.
Some heavy, heavy, heavy comments from one Bugsy McGraw, but Eric Embry has an ally that is going to be hard to put down. We'll be back.
If you rip this expensive car seat, you'd have to mend it with tape. But when new car manufacturers mend rips on the assembly line, they look like this, good as new. Now, you can use the same fabulous process at home. New Minute Mender makes almost invisible repairs quickly, easily on vinyl and leather and fabric. Repairs furniture, handbags, luggage, coats, and much more. Just match, patch, and blend. Mend rips, holes, cigarette burns in any color vinyl or leather as easily as waving a wand. Just match, patch, and blend. Watch this actual demonstration. The rip in this expensive luggage looks hopeless, but wait. Just match the color, patch with amazing Minute Mender, then blend in the grain and look. A perfect repair. Imagine, from this to this in minutes. Watch again. Here's an ugly cigarette burn. On the left is old-fashioned vinyl repair tape. On the right, Minute Mender. Let's go. Minutes later, both holes are fixed, but the tape patch looks terrible. With Minute Mender, you can't find the repair, just like new, and look, it's strong as ever. Use Minute Mender on car seats, vinyl tops, furniture, luggage, boots, jackets, toys, rafts, briefcases, glass cases, and dozens of other things. It even repairs the most expensive Naugahyde and leather. The Minute Mender kit contains everything you need to make hundreds of dollars worth of instant at-home repairs. Minute Mender, just $12.95 with an absolute money-back guarantee. Act now, and we'll include free this valuable fabric repair kit. Makes almost invisible repairs on jackets, curtains, clothing of all kinds, and you never thread a needle. The fabric repair kit, yours free with amazing Minute Mender. Don't wait. Call now for rush delivery. Here's how to order.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-241-8444. That's 1-800-241-8444. Or send $12.95 to Minute Mender, Box 8325, West Palm Beach, Florida, 33407. But for fastest delivery, use your credit card and call toll-free 1-800-241-8444. That's 1-800-241-8444.
Waiting now for Bugsy McGraw and a late arrival here in the ring for obvious reasons. Here's our ring announcer.
This match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit from Indiana, weighing 307 pounds, Mr. USA Bugsy McGraw. His opponent from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing 265 pounds, Steve Seibert.
Bugsy McGraw moving out against Steve Seibert. One fall, 10-minute time limit. McGraw opens up with a charge on Seibert, and now letting explode with everything he's got. McGraw arm whips him into the screen rope, catches him with a backdrop coming off the rope. Seibert back on his feet. McGraw closes in once again, and McGraw just all over his man. Man, Bugsy McGraw, as wild as I have ever seen him, that adrenaline really flowing. And of course, after his comments of what happened earlier here regarding Eric Embry, it's certainly understandable. McGraw, just in perpetual motion, moves against Seibert again. And Seibert, Jerry, he just hasn't had a chance yet at all.
It seems to me that Bugsy McGraw is out for one thing. That's to make Steve Seibert suffer a little bit. It looks like he's had the opportunity to take him all the way out a few times. But Bugsy McGraw, like you said, Gordon, has got that adrenaline flowing, and he's punishing Seibert right now.
McGraw crashing down across the chest of Seibert, hooks the far leg. Buddy Colt, count of three, the count of three with Buddy Colt. And the victor in this match, Mr. USA, Eric Embry's newfound ally, Bugsy McGraw. Championship prices will be in effect for championship wrestling this coming Monday night in West Palm Beach at the West Palm Beach Auditorium. Advanced ticket information, call 683-6012. Before I run down the card for the matches this coming Monday night in West Palm Beach, let me remind all of you, championship wrestling will be held in Okeechobee this coming Friday night. That'll be this coming Friday night in Okeechobee at the Crystal Lake Resort. And the spoiler will be on hand to defend his Florida heavyweight championship. And then championship wrestling will be held Saturday night in Fort Pierce at the St. Lucie County Civic Center. There will be a world title match there, a TV title match, and a host of other great events. Now then, this coming Monday night at the West Palm Beach Auditorium, NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair defends his title against former world champion Jack Briscoe. In a special challenge match, the Spoiler and Buzz Sawyer, who are closely aligned with J.J. Dillon, take on Bugsy McGraw and Eric Embry. Charlie Cook goes after Fast Eddie Mansfield in the Florida TV title. Hangman Bobby Jaggers and Ray Stevens, tag team partners against Jerry Briscoe and Ron Ritchie. Dave Sierra takes on Chick Donovan. There will be three other matches this coming Monday night. to take a moment out of talk to Bugsy McGraw and Eric Embry. A tough assignment Monday.
It is, baby. Tough. The word is war. You understand me? War. And then sides are drawn. Sawyer and the spoiler and J.J. Dillon on one side. Well, I want to assert my words right now, and I want you to hear them plain and clear. When it comes to Emery, this young man right here, you understand me? Look at me now, because this is serious, baby. When it comes to this young man, his head's been split open by greed and ego. When it comes to this young man, you want his soul, you want his blood. I'm going to tell you right now, you're going to have to walk through me. I swear.
Mr. Sully, as I watch Bugsy McGraw walk from the dressing room to the ring, I see a sea of flags, American flags, the most beautiful flag in the world. And it confused me. I didn't know why. But after what this man, my Papa Bear, did for me, I understand why. I want to be the man to wave the flag for Bugsy McGraw, and I want to see a sea of flags in West Palm Beach. Spoiler, J.J. Dillon, Buzz Sawyer, you got your nose in it now. Last week there, you split my head. They carried me out on a stretcher. I went to the hospital. They took x-rays. Hey, I didn't know whether I was going to live or die, man. And it's all come to a head in West Palm Beach. Bugsy, I believe in you. And all I can say is you believe in me, and I won't let you down. Oh, man, I won't let you down.
It's all going to happen Monday night at the West Palm Beach Auditorium. Will J.J. Dillon, the spoiler, and Buzz Sawyer have some comments?
You know, Buzz, I once had an old dog bothered by one tiny little flea. But a little flea powder and an oversized flea collar took care of that problem. But now I'm confronted with a human flea that they're trying to pass off as Nitro Eric Emery. But he is a problem. But I've got the solution, don't I?
Right here's your solution, Mr. J.J. Dillon. You got it right here, and let me tell you one thing. Bugsy McGraw and Eric Emery, you snotty-nosed little boy, I'm going to take care of you, and with the spoiler in my corner, it's coming fast, and you're going down.
NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair had these comments regarding Jack Briscoe and the title.
You might know, no sooner does Ric Flair become the world champion, than who do the promoters in Florida come up with for him to wrestle? None other than the former world champion himself, Jack Briscoe, and one of the few men that can say he holds a victory over Ric Flair. Well, times have changed, Jack Briscoe. You aren't the world champion anymore. You're looking now at the wealthiest, best-looking, flashiest athlete of all time. And now he is the new National Wrestling Alliance world champion. And, brother, I didn't buy this. I went out and took it because I'm the greatest athlete mentally and physically of all time. Briscoe, I know what you're thinking. Get the Nature Boy in Florida, and we're going to take that belt away. Well, Briscoe, you may have been a great world champion, and sure, you're a great athlete, but you're going to have to fight for everything you've got to take this from me. The Nature Boy coming to Florida, and keep it as gold. Be ready, Briscoe. Woo!
Jack, you hold a victory over this man.
I hold 3 victories over him, Gordon. He may be the world's champion now, but he knows the agony of defeat, and he knows the pain of the figure four leg lock. I've met the man on 3 different occasions, and I've defeated him on 3 different occasions. And this is my greatest moment of all, going for Ric Flair, going for the World Championship for the 3rd time against a man that I've beaten 3 times. Ric Flair, say goodbye to the belt.
The magic number could be 3, and the magic night is this Monday night in West Palm Beach.
Another reason why the switch is on to WIRK.
Every Saturday at noon, I listen to the show about the 1960s. I love the music and the host, Gary Owens.
You know, I know there's still a bunch of people out there who don't believe that you could take delivery of a car today at Adams Chevrolet and Federal Highway in Delray Beach for just $49. Well, I want to guarantee you that that's all it takes when you get in here to take delivery, just $49. Would you hurry up? Let me show you what you're going to find when you get here. How about this? A 78 Omni, only $49, $129 a month. Here's a 77 Cordoba, $99 a month. This is going to last. How about this? A 77 Newport, $2,588. I mean, is there any more that I have to tell you?
Sunshine Service is a daily telephone call to older people who live alone to check on their safety, provide friendly conversation, and get help when it's needed. If you or someone you know would like to receive this free service, call today. Sunshine Service, a program of Crisis Line information and referral.
This match won for the 10-minute time limit. from Paradise, California, weighing 245 pounds, Mike Bond. His opponent from Hollywood, California, weighing 226 pounds, Golden Boy Chick Donovan.
Chick Donovan moving up against Mike Bond. Both of these men with impressive amateur backgrounds. Chick Donovan's grandfather, by the way, lightweight boxing champion. Donovan comes from quite an athletic background. His dad and himself and Mike Bond, of course, very active in football. Of course, the football season at about the turnaround point in the season, Jerry, and a lot of the youngsters have had quite a year.
That's right, Gordon. You know, an organization doesn't get much mention, a bunch of limelight, and they sort of like it like that, is the Police Athletic League. They have a team here today, the young team. They call themselves the Lions, and if anybody gets a chance to see the PAL leagues, they should go out, because our off-duty policemen, they devote a lot of time to these young men, and they're well-deserved, and they should be recognized a little bit more.
They certainly should, and certainly Corporal Larry Siegel and all of the members of the PAL, our congratulations to all of them for the outstanding work they do with the youth here in the Bay Area, and of course PAL all over the United States. Very, very active organization. Chick Donovan holding an advantage right now on Mike Bond, has Bond down on one knee. Donovan, you can see the excellent muscle conformation and great muscularity here, but it is Bond trying to press that advantage, and look at this, Donovan breaks it up very nicely. So the Golden Boy.
You know, Gordon, in amateur wrestling, you come up, you face a man like Bond, who's about 6'4", you know. A lot of times, these are the type of guys you like to wrestle, but a lot of times, they get you down, they wrap those legs around, they cross that body ride, you get those leg scissors on you. It's very difficult, but a man with, like, Donovan's strength, you see him using that strength there a little illegally, but he did display his strength. He was able to take Bond right off his feet.
Donovan now with a front chancery direct on Mike Bond. Bond, of course, whose major in the university was criminology, but a great athlete, has excelled all of his life in athletics, and is now in the pro ranks in his rookie year and getting a liberal education once again. Bond now in a good move, had Donovan down. It's Bond moving in against him. Another hip lock takedown, and again, Bond was one step ahead of Donovan. Surprisingly fast for a man 6'4".
Well, he is, and it all goes back to the training, Gordon. These young men, they train constantly, and they're always thinking about their sport, and you've got to be successful. You're a young rookie. You're trying to learn everything. You take on all challengers. A lot of them you get beat. A lot of them you win. But it's experience. When you see a beautiful, beautiful suplex there, Chick Donovan displays some more of that strength. But what determination Mike Bond has by coming out of it, kicking out on a count of one.
And it is Donovan in behind his man once again. This is a rear chin lock now. And difficult to tell from this camera angle, but it appears that Donovan may, yes, he did, have that knee squarely between the shoulder blades of Mike Bond. And now Donovan, a series of percussions to the chest. Donovan now using the flat of the foot very effectively. Donovan wearing protection on the left knee. Bond wearing those knee pads on both sides. And now it is Donovan. But Bond coming off the ropes, and Bond in trouble. Bond slowly coming back to his feet.
That had to sting Bond. He got him right with a heel of that foot right across the forehead, and you can see Bond when he came up holding his head. It had to sting him, knocked him a little silly, because he's coming right back and taking Chick Donovan from one side of the ring to the other.
Now the hip lock takedown. Unusual application of that. Does not keep the side headlock. Prefers instead to release his man. Now Bond tried to send him for a backdrop, and Donovan, good counter. Excellent counter. As Bond tried to get him into the high backdrop, Donovan blocked him very nicely, went into a reverse neckbreaker, and scored the pinfall on Mike Bond. There's your victor, the Golden Boy, Chick Donovan.
Action TV.
Hi, Bob.
Hey, Max, come on over here. This is my buddy Max, the serviceman. He makes sure everything you rent from Action stays in top working shape.
And Bob here makes sure when you rent from Action, you never have to pay extra for service calls, parts, or labor.
That's right. Action makes it as easy as possible for people to get the better things in life. One way was to get rid of those lousy credit checks.
And you can rent to own.
That's right. You can rent to own this color television right now by calling Action. What is it we always say, Max?
With Action, you never have to be alone.
Don't miss your boat, the Island Queen River boat. Travel through history and enjoy a genuine Mississippi paddle wheeler right here in the Palm Beaches. Take a refreshing cruise on beautiful Lake Worth. See the sights of Singer Island and the mansions of Palm Beach. Relax and enjoy. Don't miss the Island Queen River boat, leaving daily at 10, 12, 2, and 4 p.m. next to the Blue Heron Bridge in Phil Foster Park on Singer Island. It'll be a trip you'll never forget.
My husband and I have a small business. Recently, when we needed some advice, we called SCORE at the Small Business Administration. The counselor who was assigned helped us a great deal, and at no cost. SCORE is the Service Corps of Retired Executives. It's successful business people from all fields helping small business owners. It's available to you. Call SCORE at this number. Ask SCORE for help.
This week's Take 5 concerns Barry Windham Mulligan. He's planning on coming back. He wants to get the Florida heavyweight title back. Now, as some of you may remember, Barry Windham did lose the Florida heavyweight title to Dory Funk Jr., but he did not lose it in a match. Barry Windham was involved in a car accident that was serious enough that he could not come and make the match with Dory Funk Jr. Somehow, Dory Funk managed to put a clause in the contract that stated that if Barry Windham did not make it to the match, he would forfeit the title. Therefore, Dory Funk Jr. did gain the title. I've had a lot of people writing me questions at letters, asking me questions about why he is using the name Barry Mulligan. Barry Windham is the son of Blackjack Mulligan, a great wrestler. He was a great football player. Also, he played for the New York Jets. He went to the University of Texas in El Paso. Barry went to West Texas State. He decided he wanted to make a name for himself, so he went under the name of Barry Windham. But now that he has made a name for himself, he's decided that he will use the name of Barry Mulligan. Now, some of the other great men that have come from West Texas State, who are not only wrestlers, of course, Dusty Rhodes, but also Mercury Morris, Bobby Duncan, Stan Hansen. There are a lot of great athletes that come from Texas. Now, Barry is a really versatile wrestler, and since he couldn't be there, I thought maybe I would show some tapes of him. We have tapes of him wrestling Nikolai Volkoff and Chris Markov, so why don't we take a look at those?
Barry Windham has, I think, become sort of the golden boy of wrestling.
Well, he has become that, but he's certainly not Dusty Rhodes' little stooge. He might be a lot of things, but Barry Windham is a stand-up person.
Certainly no question. Hell, Nikolai Volkoff just found out, too. With his tactics, Barry Windham fought fire with fire.
Well, Buddy Coates knows all the secrets. He knows how to work himself around the man now where he can see what he's doing, because at times Buddy Coates was maneuvering himself around and trying to hide from the referee. So he knows the secrets.
Windham caught Volkoff a beautiful shoulder smash that time, took him off. Volkoff, like a great big grizzly bear, back on his feet once again, though. Tremendous second effort on the part of Windham. Up and over his man as Volkoff tried to press him above his head. Barry, missing with that rolling reverse, caught him with a forearm, and Volkoff,
he
outside the ring.
Out there, Gordon, it looked like. Both men hit with such force, it was unbelievable when young Barry come off there. He did a back row, come right off of that elbow.
Obviously, cut down that breathing capability. You're going to cut down the... wow! Windham catching that time. Came off tremendous forearm that caught Markov staggered him. Markov charges in, however. Good leapfrog by Windham. Up, beautiful flying dropkick by Barry Windham. Volkoff up there on that ring apron. And Windham now after Volkoff and Markov. punches him from behind. And it is Markov colliding with Volkov, both men down. A count of three, and Barry Windham, seizing that opportunity, heads up on Barry Windham, no question about that.
Barry Windham Mulligan will be returning to Florida using his own name. I'm sure he'll be going after the spoiler, hopefully to regain the Florida heavyweight title, which he thinks is rightfully his. That's our Take Five for this week.
I'm doing it with Rose.
We're doing it with Rose.
I'm doing it with Rose.
Rose Auto Stores presents this Fram Amelie package. 5 quarts Amelie heavy duty 30 or 40 weight motor oil, Fram oil filter, Fram air filter, quart of motor flush, and free instructions on how to do it yourself. All for only $10.88 at any Rose Auto Store. Register to win a free Indy style car for Christmas at every Rose Auto Store.
You know, here at Adams Chevrolet and Federal Highway in Delray Beach, of course, all it takes is $49 to take delivery. Of course we have the lowest prices. Of course we have the greatest terms. But I want to tell you something. We are a little overstocked in 81 Citations. So we're going to blow them all out, and you are going to save a whole bunch of cash. Because I tell you, see what this is? That's an invoice. That's history. You come in and grind out the best deal you can below invoice. So would you hurry up and get in here or call me for details at 278-3225?
I'm a lifesaver. I help save someone's life by donating just a pint of blood. It only takes 30 minutes. It's so quick. It's so easy. They check my blood pressure and my iron count, too. How about you? To help save a life, call the Palm Beach Blood Bank, 832-3653. Now remember that, 832-3653.
Join the lifesavers at the Palm Beach Blood Bank.
Sail into a great PM Monday night with Rockin' Me. We'll meet America's colorful singer-songwriter Jimmy Buffett when he comes home to South Florida for a concert.
We'll also meet the Queen of Cosmetics, Mary Kay, and discover why she commands the loyalty of thousands.
Linda Harris will travel to a spectacular lake that's changing the bleak Utah desert.
And Chef Tell has a good idea for your Thanksgiving turkey. All that and a lot more coming up Monday night on PM Magazine, so join us.
This match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Ohio, weighing 235 pounds, Gordon Nelson. His partner from Cincinnati, Ohio, weighing 210 pounds, Dorv Roach. Their opponents from Homosassa, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, Rick Oliver. And from Missoula, Montana, weighing 275 pounds, Wolfman Savage.
Wolfman Savage and Rick Oliver going up against Gordon Nelson and Dorv Roach. I've just been handed a note. And next week here on Championship Wrestling 81, Buzz Sawyer goes up against your brother, Terry, Jack Briscoe. Goes up against Jack Briscoe, the $5,000 on the line, and with an extended time period of 15 minutes rather than the usual 10. So former world champion Jack Briscoe facing Buzz Sawyer, an extended time limit next week here on Championship Wrestling 81. The $5,000 challenge is up. And Sawyer indicated that a victory over Jack Briscoe next week will definitely bring him a world title match at the Bayfront Center on the 28th of this month. So Buzz Sawyer has lost none of his cockiness or his brashness, Jerry.
Well, I got a feeling J.J. Dillon might be involved in that because he expressed definite wishes that Buzz Sawyer come over to his side. But Buzz Sawyer and Mr. Dillon, they might be biting off a little bit more they can chew with Jack Briscoe. But what a match for championship wrestling they have right here on TV.
Certainly no question about it. And that's about the way Dillon would play poker, I believe. He might be holding a good hand, but not necessarily the winning hand, and he may have found that out. He's already dropped $2,000 to Eric Embry alone. So I wonder how this man Sawyer will do against Jack Briscoe. We're going to find out next week. Oliver catching Dorv Roach in the small of the back that time, using the knee very effectively. Roach driven to the canvas. Wolfman Savage making his first appearance here on Championship Wrestling. Moving out against Dorv Roach. And the Wolfman comes with quite a reputation indeed as a methodical Mayhem Master. Dutchess Dorvroach drives him back to the canvas once again. Time rapidly running out here on Championship Wrestling 81. Dorvroach driven to the canvas once again. So J.J. Dillon taking a close look at Buzz Sawyer. Buzz Sawyer against Jack Briscoe next week. $5,000 challenge, one fall, 15. Plus, of course, the Barry Windham Mulligan reporting that he will be returning. Wolfman Savage getting the pinfall. Here in the closing moments of Championship Wrestling 81, Gordon Nelson leaning over to lend some assistance, speaking on behalf of Barbara Clary and Jerry Briscoe. This would be Gordon Solie saying so long from the Sunshine State.